offering. And this is the time to be happy. Still praise to Jesus. Still praise to Jesus.
Amen. Let the church say it. This is a part that everyone can play. So I need everybody that got a purse, get your purse out. And those of you all that have a billfold, get your billfold out. Because it's offering time. Amen? It is offering time. And we're excited when the offering time has come. Because the Bible says, give me my flowers. No, that wasn't the Bible. That was a psalmist that said, give me my flowers for I can yet smell them. But the Bible says, if you give a prophet a cup of water, in the name of a prophet, you shall receive a prophet's reward. Now, how many of you all want a reward on this afternoon? How many of you all want a reward this afternoon? Pastor Kim is not asking for a cup of water because the children can give her a cup of water. But we as prophets, we're going to sow into the prophet. Amen? Amen. I'm asking that if everyone would, every adult, if you would, give us $28. Give us $28. The 20 will be your seed and the 8 will be your offering for the 8 years that she's been in ministry. Amen? And I believe she will walk away here, her and Brother David, very, very proud. If you don't have $28, get as close as you can to the $28. And those of you all that do not have jobs, nudge your neighbor and ask them for $8. Just nudge your neighbor and say, give me $8. Somebody give our babies $8. Come on. We're going to do this. We're going to do this all in the name of the Lord. But we want to bless Pastor Kim and Brother David this afternoon. So if the ushers would help me at this time, then we're going to sow into this woman and man of God. Sowing into our own self. Praise God. Praise God. Alrighty. Has everyone had a chance to give? We want to make sure everyone has had a chance to give. Alright. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, the people of God have sown their seed. Lord God, we pray, oh God, that it sows, oh God, into good ground. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we ask you to multiply it triple-fold, God, in the name of Jesus, that this offering will bless Pastor Kim and Brother David, Lord God, that they will continue on to run this race and do your will and to do your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Next, we're going to have another choir selection. Yes. Choir selection.
Christ Refuge.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
tragedies, all commonplace. All kinds of diseases, will I slip in no way? Economy's down, people don't get enough pay. But as for me, all I can say is thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Yeah. Folks without homes are in the streets, and the drug habits, some say, they just can't be. Muggers and robbers, no place seems to be safe. But you've been my protection, never is there.
Okay, next we're going to have coming up will be a word of encouragement by Pastor Yolanda Brown.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. I thought this was a celebration. If this is a celebration, baby, you need a tonight.
Amen.
8 years in the ministry, you can have your seats.
Come on now.
8 years. I don't believe people stay in church 8 years anymore.
Yeah.
So for pastors them to stay 8 years, I think they deserve the honor. Amen.
Amen.
Because it is hard pastoring now.
It is.
It's hard pastoring now. If you correct the people, you forget to say hi to the people. You say talk to other people more than you talk to somebody else. Baby, they're getting ready to leave your church.
Amen. Come on now.
I'm sorry. I thought that was just only a crash reference. But we got to learn to get out of ourselves. When God placed you somewhere and you know you're growing, stay under the leadership and get the correction and the training you need, that baby, one day you can be standing and sitting where they are sitting.
Amen.
Because we got too many fly-by-night preachers. They get saved today and they'll preach it tomorrow. Oh, let me take a little deeper. They've been saved 2 weeks and they become apostles. I'm sorry, y'all. See, we got to learn to keep it real. Amen? Because we want the real Christians. That's the one that got a solid foundation. Somebody that's been through some things, still got the scars on them to prove it, baby.
Come on now.
We talking about the one that sat in church over 20 years. They nearly kicked me out and told me to go start a church. I thought I was going to take them to church I was at. They said, no, we think you need to go out to Raymore, Missouri and tear up Raymore. So I went to Sugar Raymore. I am the first black female preacher, police chaplain in Raymore. I said it wasn't good enough just to be the first black female preacher out there.
Come on now.
I had to go mess with the police department. So when they see CRCC, they don't mess with that pastor, y'all don't mess with her. I said, y'all better not try to stop me. I'm praying for y'all. Amen, but truly we thank God for being here. This is my friend. The very first time I met her, I was in my first year of starting Christ Refuge Community Church in Belton, Missouri. And I called her and asked her to come and she said, I'll be right there. And I thank God because a friend will come and put everything else aside. Amen? Amen. So that's a true thing. So I thank God for her because her heart is real. She's genuine. She's not somebody that you can call me back. Get in touch with my secretary. And if my secretary says I can come, I'll come. Hello.
Come on now.
I thought the Bible said if you want friends, you must first show yourself friendly. So I thank God for her. We've been friends for going on 3 years now. I've been pastoring 3 years come July, I made 3 years in out in Raymore, amen. And truly God is just blessing, so I'm you like my mentor. I just watch you because I see how you're growing and I said that's gonna be us. 8 years, that's gonna be us.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We're already looking for a new building because we're outgrowing Raymore.
Yes.
Come on now.
All right.
So when God blesses people, you get under the people that are blessed. Why get jealous of them? Why talk about them? Baby, if you see God blessing somewhere, learn to get up under it. Learn to say, I'm gonna be right here with you. And I want the blessing. I want the anointing to follow me. Amen. But we got so many jealous people, they ain't funny. In the ministry. They go to y'all church. Y'all jealous of one another, supposed to be praying for one another. But we gotta learn to shake ourselves and get in the right position and say, Lord, here am I. Use me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Amen? Amen. So that means I'm not worried about what you got on or what you're doing, what you look like. Amen. Baby, like I tell people, if your hair ain't long enough, now you can go buy it. Amen. Yes, it's mine. I bought, paid for, like I received to prove it. We gotta learn to encourage one another. I don't care whether you're a pastor, preacher, apostle, teacher, just a lay member. Learn to encourage somebody. Because baby, somebody's going through just like you are. If we got anybody in the house that's not going through, please raise your hand.
Come on here.
Let me see.
Okay. Now everybody that's going through something, please raise your hand.
Come on here. Witness. Come on now.
So that means we need to be encouraging each other. So let me tell you what God did for me, because if he did it for me, he gonna do it for you. Because God said he's no respecter of person. What I've done for one, I'll do for another. But we don't think like that because we didn't got too cute now.
Amen.
That we didn't got our own hairdo. We got on our own class, our own style. I'm too cute to pray today. But I tell CRCC I'm never wearing nothing I can't get down on the floor and pray for somebody. Yeah. Amen.
Amen?
Amen? Because these clothes can go to the cleaners.
Come on.
I'm worried about your soul. So thank God for pastors that labor,
yeah,
that feed you the word,
amen,
that's not feeding you some storybook stuff.
Amen.
Y'all seeing the fruits come to pass? Everybody that's a part of this ministry, stand on your feet and you praise your pastor.
Yes, thank you,
Lord. Give honor to your pastor. Now, when I say give honor to your pastor, I want you to yell out their name. Say the last name, make it easy, all right? Say it loud, okay? One, two, three.
Yeah.
You forgot their name? Oh, we gonna pray for them. They don't got a name. All right, on the count of three, you gonna yell out their last name. Everybody know it, right? Y'all love your pastor?
Yeah.
Everybody said, we love you, pastor.
We love you, pastor.
Love you, co-pastor.
We love you, co-pastor.
Okay, so we gonna yell out their name, all right?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Yeah.
You can have this seat. Before I get my seat, I want everybody in the house to yell out Pastor Young and her husband, co-pastor. Let's say God bless them. Amen. One, two, three.
God bless you.
God bless you. Y'all pray for Christ's Refuge Community Church.
By missionary Rosemary Parks.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
We would like to honor Bishop Kenneth Hinton, New Beginning Worship Church, to bring the meat to us today. Thank you.
Let's give the Lord a hand of praise. Is that the best you can do for God? I don't understand how you can sit in your seat and say, give God a hand of praise. Celebrate with you. 8 years. 8 years seems like 100 years when you're pastor. Nobody knows what it's like to stand in these shoes. I tell people, don't get excited when you see the suits and the dresses, because you don't know what goes on behind closed doors. Sometimes people look at the glitter. But they don't know that when you step into these shoes, every demon, every devil, every principality, every power begins to target you and your family. Yes. And you have to be able to stand strong. Somebody say, stand strong. I'm going to ask the choir for one more number, if I may. I love that song, The Sanctuary is Key Still Here.
Yeah.
Thank you. Let me know it's in the holy place.
Yeah.
I come and bring the word of God as God has given to me. Give the choir another hand clap. Come on, give it up.
Thank you.
God, how many know he's in the holy place? If you're looking for him, he's in the holy place. Glory to God. Give God another hand clap. I don't know what kind of spirit you got. In my spirit, the Bible said make a joyful noise unto the Lord. All too quiet. I don't know who God's been good to. If he's been good to you, get up on your feet and give him the glory that's due him. Lord, we thank you for the word of the Lord. Amen. For the excitement, it is certainly good to be here. My Pastor Kim, David, and David, I'm going to celebrate with you. Amen. 8 years of ministry. It is just good to be a part of Pastor Kim and her husband. Just good to be connected. We're connected with blessed folk. I know that anointing has a way of running down. Say amen. Give us somebody that's blessed. Amen. And so we know these two are blessed, but we separate them. Amen. This afternoon, I was looking at this word, Pastor Kim. I got the theme about 11 o'clock last night. I just got off the airplane. My phone went beep, beep, beep. And so I looked and saw the theme, but it was all right, though. Amen. Because I know when you're preaching, you know how to merge things. Amen. So scripture has a way. You can merge the scripture together. So what the Lord had given me, the scripture, but I do want to recognize your theme. And I want you to look at somebody and say, God is going to do it. Well, y'all didn't say that like you meant it. You have to prophesy to your own self sometimes and say, God is going to do it. I mean, whatever your it is, look at somebody and say, whatever your it is, God is going to do it. What is your it? He's going to do it. According to the word of God. I mean, we must believe the word.
Amen.
Y'all got quiet on that one too. I said you must believe the word. The preachers didn't even say amen.
Amen.
Let me repeat that again. You must believe the word.
Amen.
Amen. I really discovered that we're living in strange times. Strange season for the church. I really believe the 21st century has lost its sight. We're spending more time talking about each other. And a whole lot of people listening to the talk too. The devil is cutting our throats and drinking our blood. The church is simply not letting it happen. I'm wondering why. Again, the guns are still barking in the streets. Wondering why the summer has ended and we're still not saved. When you talk salvation, salvation is more than just going to heaven. What about the salvation of the earth? The real truth of the matter is they're more depressed Christians than I ever met in my life. Come on, y'all talk to me. Many of them are that close to suicide. Literally. When it comes to settings like this, it's real difficult to get people to really praise. Because we're so used to focusing on our flesh or our soulish. And to begin to focus on our spirit. Understand that when you get ready to praise God, you have to forget about the cares of the world. And allow God to minister to your spirit. And I'm discovering the church is in a position that she don't wake up. The Bible, and I tell people what's wrong with our world is not the sinners in the world. It's the Christians. Because of my people that are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. Then what I hear from heaven, I will forgive their sin and I will heal the land. So the world is not messed up because of the people in the world. It's messed up because we don't know how to get it together yet. Come on, y'all, talk to me. We don't know how to get it together yet. We're waiting for God to bless us. God said, but I'm waiting on you to bless me first. Can't bless God in your flesh either. Amen. I feel anointing. I'm going to preach ready to say amen. Amen. Something's wrong, and I'm already preaching. That's because I give you scripture. Don't worry, I'll get to it. Something is seriously wrong apostolically. And when I say apostolically, I'm not talking about one is Pentecostalism. I'm talking about the fivefold ministry that should be in full operation. Where we are coming together apostolically to move in such power that the devil got to back off. The the real truth is what I've discovered. The church is still backing up. She is depressed. She's in bondage. She's economically in bondage. She doesn't have money to do ministry. Why? Because she is in bondage. And let me tell you something. When you follow God, you're not supposed to be in bondage. Because I'm a Christian, do not participate in a recession. Come on, y'all better talk to me tonight this afternoon, because I'm going to pray for you, say amen or not. Say amen. Something is wrong with the church. I'm telling you. Church in Kansas City, something's wrong with the church. Let me tell you something. We should be winning souls to Jesus. But we're just having church. And even that is not going too good. Why? Because we get together, we jump, we shout, and go home secretly depressed. Even this afternoon, I'm telling you, it was difficult to saturate the atmosphere with glory. Because in order to get the presence of God, you must praise. But the presence is not enough. Praise gets the presence. But worship gets glory. Come on, y'all better talk to me. Worship gets glory. And let me tell you something. Presence alone is not enough. You can go to 1 Samuel 4. Israel was going to battle, Pastor Kim. And she thought if we could get the Ark of the Covenant, the presence of God would win the war. When got the Ark of the Covenant, went to battle, 4,000 soldiers died. And then more died later. Why? Presence alone was not enough. You still bashing over the presence. And what you really need to win the battle is the glory of God. And the glory of God is an indefinable, mysterious that accomplished the divine event. In other words, when God gets ready to do anything, he sends the atmosphere. He shows up and then leaves. And then the atmosphere so sinks with God until we can't even handle it. Because the glory shows up and gets waiting. Come on, talk to me. Next thing you know, you can't keep your foot from moving. You can't sit in your seat and be still. Because once the glory of the Lord comes upon you, you can't help but praise him. Moses said it. Watch this, Moses. Moses said it. Says, show me your glory, and I'll be satisfied. God says, Moses, I'm going to do something for you I've never done before. Put my hand over your face. And I'm going to walk by you. And when I walk by you, I'm going to show you my hand part. That word hand part means the atmospheric disturbance after the reality is gone. God shows up and leaves. And the mountain shakes. And smoke comes out of the crater. And Moses fell on his face. But Moses hadn't even saw God. All he saw was the afterglow. And the afterglow caused Moses to be lit up in the face so much that he put a veil on his face. Because when you really get into the glory of God, something about your countenance changes. You're still the same old nasty Christian. After the glory comes on you, you're still meeting in a rattlesnake. You're still running, gossiping, and slandering. When the glory comes on you, for real, you can't fornicate. Oh yeah, you're telling no. You got to go. Because I got another man. Another man is in my life. Another man, another woman, and I don't need you. I don't need you to identify or define me, because now the glory is upon me. And since the glory is upon me, my life has shifted. So I'm going to cancel your phone. Because anything that takes out the kingdom did not come from God. Come on, talk to me. I start canceling. listening phone numbers.
Yeah.
I started learning how to get into the presence.
Yeah.
Instead of watching the television, pressing past the lazy boy chair and the remote control. Because in the presence of the Lord, there's fullness of what?
Glory.
And I realized living in a wicked world, even the family system is not functioning the way it's supposed to function. Because in many families, it's dysfunctional. And dysfunction simply means it does not operate the way it was created. Why? Because the family is not praying like they used to pray. Yeah, we have got to a point that we watch more TV than we do pray. And so when we come to church, we bring that same old nasty spirit to church and wonder why God ain't filling the house. Ichabod is on the doorpost. Come on, talk to me. How many know most churches have escorted God out of the church? I was gonna deal with Numbers 11. You read it when you get home. It's gonna merge Ephesians 3. Put it together. I discovered that even in Ephesians, Paul talks about, listen, the tribulation that I'm going through is because of you.
Amen.
How many know pastors suffer because of you?
Amen.
Say that.
They can't get ministry done because of you.
Come on.
Come on, y'all. Stay with me. Stay with me. Stay with me. Don't be distracted. The enemy loves to distract you when God's Spirit says something to you. Amen. That's why whenever God starts speaking, we need to start walking around the walls.
Amen.
See, when God starts moving, we need to learn how to respect and reverence the house of God.
Amen.
And keep your feet and sit down. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
Because while you're walking, you're going to miss something. Now, if you have to go, that's another thing. Say amen.
Amen.
But we need to reverence the house of God because God's about to do something. Say, God's about to do something.
God's about to do something.
And we've got to be reverent and open to what God's about to do. And I discovered that pastoring people are not easy.
Amen.
Because many times they will not obey the scripture about bringing the tithes and offerings to the storehouse.
Right.
And the next thing you know, you have to carry the burden. Of how the light bill's gonna be paid. Come on, y'all, talk to me.
Come on, man.
People of faith, come on, talk to me. And so pastoring people are not easy. So Moses says, listen, Paul says in Ephesians 3, he talks about tribulation. I'm gonna show you my tribulations. He said, listen, the tribulation I'm going through for you.
Amen.
You've caused my tribulation. Many things the pastors go through, the people caused. I mean, if you would just pay your tithes and offering, we could go to sleep at night.
Amen.
Uh-huh. Most pastors pay bills out of their own pockets.
Yeah.
Most of them do. Come on, talk to me, pastors.
Yeah.
Most of them pay, amen, the bills out their own pocket. And then when you spend all your money, now they're wondering why you can't pay your own bills.
Yeah.
Come on, y'all, watch this. Moses said, Paul said, I'm going through this tribulation because of you. And then I looked at Paul, I looked at Moses, I went to Numbers 11, and I want you to turn there in your Bible and watch what Moses says. Look at Numbers 11, verses 1 through 12. Watch Moses. Numbers 11. I usually don't read, but 5 scriptures. I've been to seminary. They teach you, you know, do your introduction to preschool. 3 points and what? And close. So I am seminary trained. I recognize that when God gets ready to speak, you have to get it the way God gave it. Watch this. Moses is dealing with the children of Israel here.
Amen.
And when I read this text, I begin to relate to Moses and understanding if the pastor can. So you have to continue to believe that God's going to do it. That's what I say. I think God's going to want. Do it. Amen. So watch this. Start with verse 1. Ready? Read it for me. Go. Read loud for me. Ready? Say go.
And when you cried, it depleted the Lord, and the Lord heard it, and his anger was
How many know that it displeases God when you murmur?
Yeah.
It displeases God when you complain. Because that's not the act of faith. And I always tell people, faith, most people believe that faith is the substance of things hoped for, and they quote the scripture. But I say, what is faith? Or what is the opposite of faith? And they say to me, well, the opposite of faith is doubt. And I teach, that's not true.